Buddha. To another video, man. Just a quick rundown. These are the stats on Latrell. This dude is a beast, man. Feel free to pause or whatever you want to do. Now, coming into this game, I predict this dude gonna go over 2,000 receiving yards. Because right now in NCAA, second behind Jones. But as far as receiving yards, this kid is just in the league by himself. Lead the nation in receiving yards, touchdowns, 80-yard touchdown. He got 5 drops on the season, but That's one knock. That's the one thing about him. But right here, the DB fell asleep on 4th and 3, and we convert. Latrell picks up 28 on the play, 2nd and 13. They already up 7-0, so we got to be on our P's and Q's because every team that we face, they're going to try to knock us off, man. Right now, we rank number 3 in the country, 3rd and 6th, and across the middle, your boy Latrell is in the end zone. Let's go. We under a minute remaining. We definitely want to break loose this tie ball game 7-7. 2nd and 10. We call for the pass. Bo Nick set us in stride. We pick up 22. 1st and 10. Cross the middle once again, dragging that defender in the end zone for a 17-yard touchdown pass. Catch 1st and 10. Across the middle. This dude is just unreal, bro. This dude is unreal. He find the end zone once again. As we kind of cruising right now, 3rd and 7. Not only that, bro, this team, our teammates is looking to do damage also, bro. Troy Franklin, he's been having a quiet season so far, but quite a couple of games. And right here, throwing it deep, and you just cannot deny the fact that this dude is a different fucking breed. As we end up thrashing Washington State, we finish with 7 receptions, 215 yards, 4 touchdowns, bro. That is unreal. Heading to another game against UCLA. They coming in at 5-1. Now, first completion of the game goes for 13, 1st and 10. And bro, that stop and go is just unreal. This dude is turning on the Jets. It's no catching this dude. As we find the end zone, 69-yard touchdown pass. 2nd and 10. The pass is caught across the middle, breaking one tackle. Could not quite break number 2. Pick up 19. 2nd and 5. One-handed catch. And that sets up 1st and goal. 1st and goal across the middle. Yo, what a way to thread the needle. And so Trill finds the end zone once again. 3rd and 12, another one-handed grab. Yo, that is crazy. 3rd and 9. To the house, to the crib. To the crib. I'm telling y'all, this dude cannot be caught once he get in the open field. This dude is going for the Heisman, man. He is definitely going for it. 1st and 10. Calling for the pass once again. This dude is just unfucking real, like unreal. I mean, is he the best wide receiver in the nation? I mean, fuck wide receiver. Is he the best player in the nation? What a way to thread the needle. Latrell picks up 20. Bro, we are steamrolling UCLA right now. 1st and 10, and that defensive back, the safety, fell asleep, and we are taking it to the crib once again. Is he the best player in the nation? Bro, we broke the receiving yards in the game. Is he the best wide receiver in the nation? Is he the best player in the nation? Should he go to the draft after this season? Bro, we got this DB. He wanted to use a map. Let's go. Great block by the teammate, man. We finished with 452, 6 fucking receiving touchdowns, 13 receptions, bro. That just really put him on the Heisman map, man. As he ended up winning that game 45-27. 2nd and 4, taking on Stanford. Our first catch of the game, and that's good for 13 on the play. 2nd and 13. You can't teach that, man. Touchdown, man. Let's go. 10-10 ball game. As we fighting Stanford once again. Hit that boy in stride. Nice pass by Bo Nix to Latrell. As we lead this game 17-10, and that boy Troy Franklin breaking multiple tackles, and he is finding his way to the end zone. But look at the blocking, bro. Look at the blocking. That's one thing that you can add to your repertoire as a receiver, bro. That stop and go once again. That's an unguardable move as we lead in 24-17 But like I said, if you can add blocking to your repertoire, you'll completely see it. As we end up beating Stanford once again, we finished with 5 receptions, 110 yards, 2 score. A little bit of a drought compared to, you know, a couple of past couple of games, but we are standing on a couple of NCAA record, couple of school records that we absolutely will break. Coming in at number 24, Utah State, 6-3. We are still number 3 in the nation at 9-0. This dude is a bigger DK Metcalf, man. That's all I gotta say. Let me know what NFL player comparison do y'all see in this kid, man. This kid got size, speed, he got it all, man. Look at NCAA record for receiving yards in a season. Is he the best player in the nation, regardless of position? And that 9 yard, actually got 9 yard rushing on the plays, 3rd and 15. And that pass is caught by none other. Torrey Franklin is doing his thing. He picks up 26, 4th and goal. Cole decided to go forward. Yo, Latrell, what other player to throw it to, man? As we lead in Utah, 13-10, across the middle of the one-handed diving reception. He loved to see it, 2nd and 7. Let's try to get the big man the ball. As we turn in on the Jets, see, we are turning on the Jets, something that you rarely see. He picks up 18 on the play, 3rd and 3. We kind of ignored the route that they gave us, but that's okay. We pick up a first down, pick up 17, a 3rd and 6. Now, Utah has definitely been fighting. They definitely been fighting. We got them with the stop and go once again. Inside the 5, man. Let's go ahead and score and put this game away. 2nd and goal. Let's go. You love to see it, baby. Let's go. This team just will not go away. 4th and 2 and calling for the most crucial pass of this game. 3rd and 6. We need this. Yo, what a way to fight, man. That's all we got for this video, man. Like, comment, subscribe. It's your boy, CR8. I'm gone.
Tree. I wanna salute every nigga who run with me, and it's a secret everything that you done with me, cause it's a couple niggas that practice loyalty, family.